step back.
Take a step back.
16 days
from
election day. Stop hurting
America. Stop hurting America. Stop hurting America. Stop hurting America, you greasy grifter. Stop hurting America, you greasy, stupid grifter.
Yes.
The greasy two-bit grifter you saw in that video was, of course, Steve Bannon. He was surrendering, which means that he didn't actually have them kill me first, which he said he would. They will have to kill me first. Or, oh, do I need to call an Uber because I really need to go surrender? And he did. He surrendered, as of course he was going to. This dude loves false bravado. Jesus. And I love that as he goes in to face his charges, he's identified for what he is. He is a grifter through and through, in every sense of the word, a massive scheming grifter. It's transparent. He's already suffered brief consequences for it. It looks like he's probably going to suffer more. He's now charged with money laundering as well as conspiracy in connection with allegations that he defrauded donors to a group aimed at building a wall along the U.S.-Mexico border. Two counts of money laundering in the second degree, one count of conspiracy in the fourth degree. And in case you haven't listened to other videos about this, or you don't understand why he's facing these charges, I cannot be clear enough. He and other people stole millions of dollars from some of the most devoted MAGA people to build a wall that they had no intention of building. They said, give us money, we'll build a wall. And they took the money and they bought jewelry and clothes and cars and yachts. And then after being caught and charged with that, he started doing a show, and MAGA people tuned in because there is no getting through to them that they're being enthusiastically scammed, willingly scammed by this guy over and over. He'll do a show from jail, and they will send him money. Guarantee it, Francesca.
Yeah, and I'm sure the woman screaming at him was a defrauded MAGA supporter, angry that she was lied to about the money going to actually build the wall. Oh, wait a minute. No, she definitely was not. But I just got to say, I have so much love for the people because I used to be one of them, living in New York, activists, kind of scrappy, made their sign. We're like, I think Steve Bannon's going to turn himself into, was it Central Booking there? You know, I don't know this woman, but I feel like I might know her. Like, and she waited there and she stood there. And yes, you got the sound. You got the tape. You greasy two-bit grifter. Stop hurting America. Mwah. I love you, whoever and wherever you are. Thank you for saying what we all want to say. And yeah, there he is. Just a little, just a smelly puppy dog, which is just it. That again, a smelly puppy dog, greater than Steve Bannon, any day of the week. None of it will actually matter to the movement. But again, he did this on behalf of Donald Trump, all the time. Who are we doing this on behalf of? Donald effing Trump. Who gets away every single time? Donald effing Trump.
He got away from the initial federal charges because of Donald Trump. But I think, look, he was basically using the MAGA movement. He was pretending to pursue a goal of Donald Trump to make himself rich. It's like the perfect grift. If I were Donald Trump, I would be furious about that. Imagine I have this goal. My like one stated domestic goal is to have this wall. And you're going to take millions from people who love me so that you can get a yacht? It's crazy, honestly, that Donald Trump actually pardoned him. Like, Donald Trump's a grifter. He's not supposed to be okay with competition for the grifting. Every one of those millions of dollars could have been millions of dollars that he stole. And he is trying, which is another added layer of irony that, like, Bannon might end up serving jail time for ripping off MAGA people. Donald Trump is sending out emails right now to do the exact same thing. How many countless tens of millions of dollars did Trump raise after the 2020 election to fight it that he never had any intention of fighting it? He makes the amount that this group raised look like absolutely nothing, but he's able to get away with it. Steve Bannon isn't powerful enough. He isn't rich enough. He's barely a living biological organism, I guess. And so he can suffer the consequences. But every single day, there's other right-wingers doing the same thing, and they're walking free.
The paper record, New York Times. Look at the Moloch right there. That's next level. Here's why. It's a desecration. It's a desecration of Independence Hall. the Constitution, the Declaration of Independence, the Liberty Bell, goes to Philadelphia, a city that's in chaos and collapsing all around you. It's crime and anarchy takes over. And he goes there. That's Moloch. Look at that. They did that on purpose. He'll always be known with that photo of him like Moloch, right?
The same modern political party labeling their opponent Moloch, who I think Moloch was actually a card I opened in a Magic the Gathering pack recently. What I love about that is he shows the not a photo, like a still from the video where you just see the red. He shows the newspaper that shows that it was red and blue. It was blue on the outside. It wasn't framed that way in the video, but that's what the set was. It was regular American colors, red and blue. Also, Steve Bannon is sitting in front of a red background. Moloch up in here. There's even like swoopy blades and stuff. The word war. What sort of subliminal message is he trying to send, Brett?
Dude, stop trying to make Moloch happen. It's not going to happen. It is so insane. So Steve Bannon has the dominant strategy for a psychopath going on. One, he is trying to gin up the base and he is attacking the Republicans and or the Democrats. And B, he's doing so in the people that are most likely to get snowed into ridiculousness, wanton conspiracy theorists. And when he says Moloch, like what an insane lexicon to use. Like that's not even saying like it's like the devil. He's bringing up Moloch. Who is that? Nobody knows unless they're so far down Bannon's rabbit hole that it just smells like whatever nacho cheese he guzzles nonstop because instead of drinking unicorn blood, he just pumps easy cheese into a vein.
Right. That first of all, that was funny. Thank you. Who is Moloch? Okay, so Moloch is a reference to a god from a long time ago. If considering that this is Steve Bannon and we're in the particular sort of satanic panic that we're in right now, if that deity was associated with one thing, what's your guess as to what that deity would be associated with?
Child sacrifice.
Did you look that up?
No.
Cause you're right. That's why he chose Moloch. That's the reference because all of the people you disagree with on politics who want to like fight climate change or whatever, they all want to consume, murder, and possibly have sex with children. That's what they want to do. That's what this movement is. That's what this movement is.
They have so transparently jumped the shark. There's only so long you can call the Democrats baby killers because of abortion, especially after you leave it up to the states that are already yours to outlaw abortion. Rather than all of you look around and say, oh my God, what do we do now that we've gotten everything we ever wanted? I guess take a nap, which is something they don't want to happen right now. They need more momentum. And so they need to make their lives huger and more ridiculous, like the Democrats are out there actively plotting to sacrifice babies to the demonic maw of Moloch.
Yep.
So stupid.
It's almost clever. It's almost clever. Steve Bannon has read a book, I guess. Most of them haven't.